Hey, Greenbelt Gandalf here. Just checking in, me and Mike Dog. We are in Prospect Park. Look at this cool thing. That's pretty neat. Huh. Somebody built a little fort in there. Look at that. Pretty cool thing. Anyway. Huh. Ancient Aztecs or something. But, there's Mike the dog. We're on the Clear Creek Trail. We're just hiking along, man. This one's for Jay Bird. Jackie, I miss you. I wish you were out here with us. We used to play guys over there on that side years ago when he was just a little boy, a little baby boy. But this is our park we used to hang out, me and my boy. So just came out here to remember those old times, missing him. He's visiting family this week. So, Jay Bird, I love you. And this walk's for you. Let's go, Micah. Let's hit it. Don't get dirty. Anyway, we're going to keep walking along. And I'll check in here in a little bit. I need a good long walk after a long, hard day like today. Anyway, so I will talk to you later. And go Clemson Tigers, right? Bye. This is where you can come to feel like you're really in the forest. If you don't listen for the cars and you just listen to the crickets and the birds and the frogs, this is where you can come. This is where you can greenbelt, all right? Me and Michael, we love to come out here. It makes me feel like I'm back home, living in South Carolina. Being able to just walk in the woods. I grew up most of my life walking in the woods. Creeks, woods, ponds, rivers. Yeah, I don't know. I'm surprised I don't miss it more than I do. I don't know what it is. Something about Colorado. I miss being in the forest, but I guess where I grew up, Irmo, South Carolina, is overgrown and overpopulated as well. So all the places I used to hike are gone. You know, the pine forests are that I used to spend days in, and they're gone. They're all subdivisions now. Monkey Dog Road is gone. Harbison Boulevard is gone. You know, so after 35 years, of course they're gone, right? That's America. That's where we're coming to. There'll be very few open places. And at least in Colorado, you can't see it, but through there is the mountains. And there's places out there where you can still go and get away from it all. It's just far away. So I spend my time here in the city trying to find places to go to get away. And this is one of them. This is out on Prospect Park, as far out as you can get. So this is where we like to go. We don't come out here often, I don't know why. Time, I guess, but this is where you can see little things like this, little creeks feeding into ponds, feeding into the Clear Creek. You know, the Clear Creek goes into the North Platte, and then from there it goes up into I think the Missouri River is where it flows into, through a couple of lakes. I don't remember the name of them, sorry. But yeah, it flows north. One of the few rivers that go north. It flows north all the way up to Cheyenne area and then starts going east. For some reason, I always thought it went south. I thought the Clear Creek ended up in, you know, the Rio Grande or something. But anyway, this is it. This is where you go. About as far out as you can get. Still touching civilization. There's houses behind me on the hill up there. Those are lottery houses. Those are houses I want to move into when I win the lottery. But you know, that's where you got to ignore some stuff. You got to use your imagination, but mostly you just got to let your soul breathe. You know, you just got to let it breathe and ignore that stuff, so you can focus on being out here and just sucking up that noise. Can you hear it? I hope the microphone on my new camera, my new phone, is good. That's what I like. Hearing the birds and the crickets and the, everything else just talk to each other. And we're gonna go off on this little side road. And it takes you behind Bass Lake. And Bass Lake is, I think it's the first lake I really fished in Colorado. Didn't do a lot of fishing when I first moved here. Didn't know you could. I was used to fishing the Broad River for stripers. Well, the Saluda River for stripers, and then the Broad River for catfish, and you know. But anyway, this is Bass Lake over there. That's a cool little pond. We're gonna go look at it real quick, see if there's any fish. If there is, we'll tell you. But my battery's chirping at me, so anyway, check in a bit. Alright, this is a spot we've never been. Micah found this one. We'll go see what's back here. He's a trail dog, man. He'll find your trail. He might lead you into trouble, but he'll find your trail. Where are we going, boy? Oh, no, we can't go back there. I ain't going through the water. Alright, dead end. Well, he could find that. It's probably a deer trail, I would think. He found it. I'll try it. He's going through all quiet. I'm like a bull in a china shop. He's a moose. He's a deer, and I'm a moose. What'll we find, boy? Nothing really, huh? I really kind of thought we might see some wildlife back here. Maybe. Hey, Micah, come on, let's go this way. Find a trail. Come on. Hey, find a trail. Go. Get me out of here. Nope. Come on. There you go. Get me out of here. All right. We just kind of ended up right back where we started. Hey. Come on. Hey. Let's go this way. Let's go this way. Yeah, we just kind of ended up right back where we started doing. We're trying to grow some trees out here between the trees that got some kind of, beetle kill. And then that's a planting site. We're not going that way. To me, that's kind of like an ancient Indian burial ground or something. They're trying to regrow the trees in Colorado. God bless them. They tore them all down. No, sir. No, so we're not going that way. They had to tear them all down for beetle kill. And then there was another tree that wasn't indigenous. They had to cut all those down too. They lost a lot of trees out here. So to me, that's like sacred. Grow some trees, man. Grow some trees. Anyway, let me see. We're out here. You can hear the interstate, but we're pretty far out. Yeah, there's where all those trees are they had to cut down. Stay, Micah. See him? Now, that looks like a... Come here. Hey. That looks like a just dead forest, so... I'm not going over that. There is something really interesting over there. It looks like a shotgun. Huge shotgun. Anyway, we'll get there in a minute. Come on. Yeah, you're all fired up, aren't you? You know those guys were up to no good. All right, I'll tell you that story in a minute, but... So there's the shotgun. That's what we call it anyway. Two pipes in the middle of the hill. I don't know why they're there. Come here, Micah. Hup. But they look like a double barrel shotgun, right? Double barrel shotgun just sticking out of the middle of nowhere. Big double barrel. But I mean, people have ruined it over the years. It didn't used to all be beat up like that, but that's okay. It's just metal. But, yeah, me and Micah, I think, stopped some kind of, some kind of plan there. So you hear me talk about it. There's homeless guys that stay out here on the Greenbelt, right? And there's a couple of them over there on that fence. When the two of them were over there, and you can't see them now, they took off, but two ladies, you know, yoga pants and tennis shoes, just walking out here in the middle of nowhere. And these two guys were beating feet after them. And we came out from over here, going this way, out of nowhere. They didn't expect anybody. And the ladies went down this way, and the two guys were running towards them. And me and Micah came out, and I didn't really think anything at first. I was just yelling at Micah. But as soon as I started yelling, man, they turned and haul ass. And now one of them standing up there kind of eyeballing me, but he ain't going to come over here. He knows better. But that makes me feel good when we come out here and we can do some good. I don't know if we did or not, but in my brain we did. I feel like there was some bad news bears going on. Sorry, I got that really focused in on my face, I can tell. So, but yeah, that's why we come out here. Not really. I come out here to get in shape or because I'm a big fat butt. But really, I mean, that's fun. Because I definitely would have loved to if they would have started something. Because I'm a pretty big guy, guys. I'm about 6'3", 300 pounds. And I don't know. Would have been fun to wrestle around. But anyway, that's not what Gandalf's about. It was just fun to be involved in. Maybe something useful. It was good to be useful. But this is Bass Lake. And it used to go all the way. You can see where it used to go. It's way down this year. And that's not usual because the Clear Creek's right there. If they wanted to fill it up, they could with no problem. They must be doing something, but that means there's bass are real condensed right now. If they survive the winter, we might come out here and catch some fish. So anyway, it was fun. It got my adrenaline pumping. Anyway, I was ready to do some I was ready to be a superhero. Anyway, I'll talk to you later. So I'm gonna sign off now. I don't know how long we walked, how far we walked, or how fast, but I know we walked probably hours, pounds, however you measure stress. I walked it off today. So I'm gonna leave you with this parting shot of this little fort here. It's pretty cool, man. Somebody put some work into it. You know, it's pretty neat. You can go on down in there. I'm not gonna. I'm a big old dude, man. I'll knock the crap out of that. Go on, Micah. Go. Hey, go on down. Go on. Go. Check it out. So there's some perspective. It goes a long way. They did a good job. Come on. Come on. Maybe it's a Bigfoot hut. I don't know. I don't know what it is. I don't know what it could be. Probably somebody just having fun. But anyway, catch yourself in the woods, man. Get yourself out here. You know, it's all over here. There's stuff even downtown by my work. It's a little tiny spot of it, but it's there. Get yourself out in the woods. Get yourself out on the Greenbelt. Calm down. Quit driving around. Quit rushing to go buy weed. Whatever you're doing here in Colorado, chill out and enjoy it. This is God's country here, man. Look at that. In a month, 2 months, all these trees will be green. We'll come back then. Because then what will happen is the spring runoff will happen. And we'll get into the water. We'll get into the rapids, the whole family. We'll do it. It's fun. All this will be green. But look at it. We got little evergreen trees poking around everywhere. You know, this is the deal. Get outside. Enjoy this place. Colorado is more than just the Broncos. More than just the Rockies. More than just interstates and highways. It's a beautiful place to live. It really is. Enjoy it. Please. And just relax. Let's quit beating each other up all the time, you know? So anyway, this is Greenbelt Gandalf signing off, getting off my soapbox. I just want to say God bless, be safe, and go Clemson Tigers. Have a great day.